Well, there it goes. I guess everything looks like it's working well. So, welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. This is Keith from Cammy's Corner. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. And I've decided to come on here because I have no sound in my game. Is that why? No, I do have sound. Okay, good. Because I'm bored and I'm doing a pretty tedious project here, and why not share this tedious project with all of you and try streaming for the first time in a very long, long time. So, to set things right, or to let you know exactly what I'm doing and where I am at my water temple. Let's go upstairs and take a look, and you will see what I'm doing. This is the water temple, or what was the water temple. I've drained it all out. I put up the blue glass on the outside, and I have this water temple. Yes. So, I eventually drained everything, then I took out the building, and then I decided to look at what type of farm I should make, and then I realized I need a bigger drop area for the guardians to fall in order for me to do the temple properly. So I am bringing this temple floor down to the proper size. Let's see what we got here. One, two, three. One, two, three. So, I'm going down three blocks at a time. Just so I feel like I am accomplishing something. So I'm just going around with my pick, going up and down rows, and eliminating blocks that are taller than a certain thing. Let's see what that thing would be. Right now, that thing would be number 31. That is the level of the farm right now, or the bottom of the farm. In order to make sure that the guardians all die, I'm digging this whole cavern out to level 22. So I actually only have three more levels to go, which is really not that grand in the grand scheme of things, but it is still gonna take some time, as each three levels takes probably 45 minutes to an hour to do. Even though I have an efficiency 5, I do not have a beacon yet. So I could, if I had a beacon, do the auto mine, which would be much faster than this. And I'll remind myself next time I decide to do a project like this, I will make sure I have enough wither skulls to make a beacon, because that's my problem. And I had died in that cave over there. There's a cave down there. And didn't know whereabouts in the cave I was. And before I found the place where I had died, I had lost all my materials. So I'm still trying to get the good stuff on my materials as my, what is that? My dagger, my sword doesn't even have looting 3 on it. So I'm not bothering to go wither skull hunting without a sword with a looting 3. And instead, I just wanted to get my frustrations out on a whole bunch of these blocks and just go down this whole row and eliminate my evil blocks that are in my way before I can make my guardian farm. And I always call things in this game evil and in my way and giving me a hard time. And sometimes feel like I give out the impression that I do not enjoy this game, but I immensely enjoy this game, and I immensely enjoy the grindy aspects of this game. So what I'm gonna do, hold on with me for a second, 'cause I'm gonna minimize this and make sure I can see my chat. Doesn't look like anybody's in the room right now, but that's okay. I didn't really let people know. I'm just gonna maximize the screen and just check every once in a while to see if there's anybody in this room. But as of right now, I'm just talking to myself. But this is kind of like a test stream, so I don't really care. Blah, blah, blah. Talk to myself. Yes. So now that I have the three wide, I can make sure I collect all the blocks that I might have missed on the way over. And then is there darkness over there? Oh, there is. What's over here? Oh. Oh. A bunch of zombies. I'm starting probably a zombie horde right now, unintentionally. Okay, well, we'll get all that figured out in the future. I'm not too worried about it. I just want this thing down. So this particular row that I'm bringing down three is where my torches are. And to make sure we don't get mob spawning, I place torches every so often. Just like anybody else. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. I think this is where my torch goes. Yes, I'm that meticulous. I'm gonna make sure. Okay, this is where my torch goes. Right there. And this is actually too low. So, we'll just forget that I was even talking about that torch that whole time. I'm very particular about it. It's kind of weird. I have some weird problems like that in my life where I'm just a little too meticulous. And other times where I'm a little not meticulous enough. Okay, so we actually don't have any torches at all on this side, right? No, there's no space to put it. You see how the torches are all five apart? I'm trying to do that over here, but so far all the torches that are supposed to go in this row don't have a block at the proper height to do it, so I'm not putting a torch there. But over here, you'll see 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So this torch can go there. That's where I want it. Three blocks below. So I just go down 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This torch can go there. Right? Yeah, that's the height. I believe that's the height. Okay. The height has been confirmed. So the next torch goes there. Yep. And we just continue now that there's more of a building here again and I can cut it out. I will know exactly where the torches go. Torch. And hello to anybody who is in the stream. Right now I do have chat kind of minimized. I do have a second monitor that I was planning on hooking up for streams in particular. But I didn't hook it up for this because this was kind of like I woke up, it's early in the morning, I'm out of work for a while, and, well, it's not really too early in the morning, but I don't feel like, I just wanted to test out the stream thing today. Just test it out a little bit, and that's what I'm doing. 1, 2, 3, 4, and the torch for this row should be right there. It's off by one, but who gives a padooty? So as you see, all my stuff has mending on it. I had to replace all this because all the gear I lost when I died in that cave over there all had mending on it. But I have a villager breeder with a villager who sell mending books for 20 emeralds, I think. And that's really cheap, especially if you have the right farms and the right villagers to trade with. So it only takes me about 15 minutes to get 9 or 10 mending books. So now that I have the row with the torches down that I usually only cut out one at a time, I go back to the four. So like I say, I had five rows in between my torches, so I do one row with the torch and I cut out a row of four. This takes much longer, but it gets a lot more done. And when I break it up with the one where I can just do one row and just place down a torch every five blocks, it really kind of breaks up the monotony of breaking this down, because doing the four rows like this, it takes a lot longer and it sometimes becomes boring, but then I finish it up with a row of one and I can just basically walk in stride and go down and take out these blocks. Yes, in-depth conversation of why I take blocks down in a certain way. And I figure when I'm doing the four also, I don't have to worry about putting down torches, so I, you know, have more focus on breaking blocks, I guess. I don't know. Psychology of block breaking 101. So, I also have a... These are projects that are in this world. This is actually a world that I play my jam series on, which is at KMA's Corner user YouTube, if you ever want to check it out. Links are probably in the description below this video feed. And I do bigger builds. I try and have some fun with them. And but mostly what ends up happening is I end up making the build and going, oh, here, this is what I made in between the last video. So with projects like this where I'm having to do lots of work, I'm thinking I want to stream it. But I have a problem because I get embarrassed streaming with people home. But right now, ooh, a creeper. Where are you going, creeper? We got you, creeper. Oops. Sometimes that bow is a little too OP. but the thing I've noticed with creepers, and the reason why I died, is that I don't have any armor with blast protection, and I still don't have any armor with blast protection on it. And if a creeper sneaks up on me and sizzles, normally I'm so distracted with other things in the around me, with my daughter and my wife and stuff, or I'm in the middle of cooking dinner, so I don't really have all my focus on the games, I won't hear the creeper sizzle. And when they sizzle when you're on top of me in 1.8 with the type of armor I have on now, I'd lose 3 or 4 bars of health, so no big deal. But now when a creeper blows up on me, I die. That's it. End of game. So if I'm caving and I'm in the middle of a cave system and I don't know where the hell I am, and I've been caving for 3-4 hours and have no clue what my coordinates are, and a creeper sneaks up on me when I'm just farting around and kills me, I don't like that. And that's what happened. I lost my gear because a creeper blew up on me and I was like, where the fuck was I? So, yeah, it was not a happy experience, especially seeing I had just got mending on all those things, and mending's not the easiest enchant to get in all your stuff. So it set me back. It took me about 5 hours to recover, replace all my gear. I lost probably 30 or so diamonds. We'll say 25. I'm probably exaggerating a little bit. We'll say 30. I lost a couple of stacks of iron because I was caving, lighting everything up down below this ocean monument like I was supposed to. And there's a creeper all the way down there. What's up with that? Oh, I don't think I shot it far enough. But I do have a better bow now. This bow has flame. I usually stay away from the flame with the bow or swords and stuff because it ends up hurting me. Did I get them? I don't know. Maybe I was just seeing things down there. So, beware. Creepers are a lot stronger, I think, from now on whenever I make a DOP type armor. I'm gonna definitely put at least a chest plate with blast protection, because I think if you had a blast protection enchant, it would keep the creepers from killing you. And maybe that's what I'm missing from my last set of armor and thinking about, is that I actually had blast protection. So let me go to the other side. See, this row is the row with just the torches, so it doesn't broken torches. It doesn't matter that I. Whatever, it goes much faster. Lost a train of thought. I'm just waking up. And I said, you know, let's do the test stream. So, test stream away, and, you know, brain ain't working. Doesn't matter. It will work someday, right? So, how do I get out of this rat-infested hole? Is that a way out? I can get out this way. So this is a pretty big area. It's 57 by 57. Actually, I think it's 59 by or 60 by 59. Something odd like that. And I'm gonna do the guard fall, which is basically based on an Etho, not Etho, Doc M design zip crowd thingy that JL2579 had, I think, came up with most of the work on it. I kind of think Zip Crowd was like, here's Doc, he's the doctor, and all the other people on Zip Crowd just gave him the ideas, and Doc took credit for it. Throwing Doc under the bus. See what happens, Doc? I invite you to a beer, especially at a place called Doc's Beach House. When you're in my town and you still don't go, I'm gonna throw you under the bus. Oh, are you sending your minions after me now, Doc? Really? The red, what was that? That's got to be strength, right? So that guy had a little extra strength on him. I have a feeling that no, I don't know why things are spawning up there. So why was I talking about? Oh, so this like why was I talking about Doc? I love Doc. His videos are awesome, and I love the series that he's doing with Etho on Hermitcraft right now. It's the type of series that got me into Minecraft Let's Plays and to begin with. Lots of fun, lots of stuff. Just seeing if there's any mobs up there. There really isn't. I've got it lit up pretty well, and that's what I want. So I'm gonna basically have up at level 61, which is where that platform is, and that's where the water will be for each channel for the guardian to spawn. They'll have three or four water blocks that they can swim around in that is too wide. And in Doc's design, he had dispensers up there that would dispense water so you could turn the farm on and off. But seeing that this farm is out in the middle of nowhere, and I'm never going to be out here unless I'm farming guardians, and specifically farming guardians, that I don't need a turn off switch that will turn off when I'm out of the area and it's unloaded. So I'm not gonna bother making, I don't know, 1,000 dispensers for this, but instead I will just have the constant water flow, which is kind of more like Guardfall that Exuma made from Hermitcraft instead of what Doc M did there. So basically there's a 4x2 area that guardians can spawn and swim around in, but basically they'll just fall right out of the four high area. And at the bottom of the four high area is, I'm gonna get rid of this spider eye, I don't need this junk. And at the bottom of it is a fence gate that is open, and that keeps the water up. But then they will fall out through the fence gate area and fall up, I think it's 35 blocks, and when they hit the ground, they explode into little pieces, and I get their guts, which are shards and whatever they drop. I don't even really know. But I do know one thing, what they drop gives me the ability to make some pretty awesome looking blocks, and the second and possibly my favorite light source in the game, which is sea lanterns. So that's why I want to do this, for the green blocks and the sea lanterns. Plus, it's kind of fun doing this type of stuff. It's a little monotonous right now, but it's kind of fun. It's playing the game, it's Minecraft, and it's what I like to do. I know modded, I could probably do this in 10 seconds, but the feeling of completion when you're doing a project this size in vanilla survival is good enough feeling for me to continue playing this. So basically, the guardians will fall that 35 foot or 35 block height. There, I'm gonna have a layer of glass there, and underneath the layer of glass will be a layer of air blocks, just so I can put a mine hopper cart on each track. There's gonna be 57 or 58 tracks going across the whole thing that will pick up the drops and drop them into a item sorter that will fill up a whole bunch of chests somewhere. And I initially was thinking I was gonna make another water temple designed on the basic one that I took down here, next to here, like over there or over there in the ocean, and that will be where all the stuff gets transported. But that was before I realized I have to dig down another, I forget how many, I gotta empty my shit. I forget how many blocks, but so it would be kind of weird to run the place from higher up. So I need some sort of station above it to make it easier for the cave not to get lit up. But I've done probably 4 or 5 hours of real life caving around here. I doubt there are any hidden caves I do not know about, so I'm not too worried about having to eliminate the caves playing around with my spawning potentials. But we will see. I'm gonna check something out real quick. Yeah, that is interesting. Where is my game? There is my game. There is still nobody in chat, so I don't really have to worry about not answering anybody's questions or saying hi. I gotta figure out a good way of doing that. I don't have a phone that actually gets reception in my place where I live, my abode, so I can't really have a phone sitting next to my computer that I can just glance over and see chat. So that's another reason why I've been kind of going, why should I bother doing a stream if I can't really get look at chat? But we do have a Kindle Fire in the apartment. I just gotta hook up the internet to it, and I think I can watch Twitch on that. I'm pretty sure. I just gotta get my ass in a row and get those things fixed. So, yep. I'm trying to think of anything else you may need to know with this. Oh, getting all these stone blocks is going to be really good, because I have a thing. If you follow Mumbo Jumbo on Hermitcraft, he just made a sky spawner, his version of the sky spawner. I have another version of his sky spawner, which is a little less resource intensive, but it works just as well, and you can get a double chest of all mob drops that you want within a couple of hours of AFK in there. So but it's Ryan and I in the middle of the ocean, and I'm thinking one of my favorite bands of all time, this is jumping all over the place, I know, is a band called Yes, and the album that got me into them was an old album called Yes Songs, which is a live album, and on the cover, Roger Dean, who's the artist for all the old Yes albums, made a awesome oil painting of floating islands, and I kind of want to recreate the floating islands. So the sky spawner is the perfect way to recreate that floating island, and that's what I'm gonna do, is I'm gonna make a floating island of that sky spawner in the middle of nowhere, so from the distance it will just look like a floating island instead of a mob spawner just floating in over some water in the middle of the ocean. I'll probably never ever really see it from the outside, but it will be a fun project to do. Putting some trees and maybe a waterfall coming off of it. I think it will be awesome. But you never know. It's hasn't been made yet, and I'm not like the end-all builder in Minecraft by no means. Anything great that I've made in Minecraft, I've copied from somebody else. That's what I do. I go, I'm gonna build a house, and then I go online and I look for tutorials of houses, and I go, oh, that one's a good one, let's follow this tutorial. I rarely go, okay, let's build a house and actually build one out of my own design. So that is something also I've gotta have to start pushing for. That is a deficit in my Minecraft playing experience. I can't be a Minecraft expert if I can't, or if I'm too afraid to build my own designs or come up with my own designs, at least. So, the Roger Dean thing, yes, it will be based on something, but it will be designed by me. I guess everybody needs to make a floating island every once in a while because they're so serene. I do want to get some horses or something up on the floating island. And I'm going to have the pond and a couple of trees up there, and of course water falling off it into the ocean. Let's see. So you see, this thing takes a while. I'm destroying the durability on my pick, and it looks like I am almost done. So I'm going to do the 4-wide row going back. Hopefully this pick will last. And because I have mending on it, we're going to do the long haul to my blaze spawner when I'm done with this row. And we can mend my pick back up. Yes, we can mend the pick up back up. I am sorry, there's no music on here. I didn't think that far ahead, to tell you the truth, for this specific stream that doesn't really exist, but maybe I might release on YouTube if I'm even actually recording this for archival purposes. I don't know if I am, if it's automatically making a video for me on Twitch or not, but we will see. And the reasoning for what I am doing is normally I would be at work right now, but I got hurt a couple of weeks ago and I'm going to be home from work for approximately another month. So I'm going to have plenty of time to stream in the morning while all you guys are doing your daily chores while I sit at home and recover from my injury. Sounds like fun, doesn't it? So that's why I'm on here right now doing what I'm doing, which is breaking blocks. Break, 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 break. I'm also a musician, kind of like Exuma. And I really want to find a song. I really want to write a song that beats per minute matches this. So when you're playing along and you're doing something menial and repetitive like this, you have a song that actually goes in the same beat as a pickaxe. A Efficiency 5 pickaxe at full speed without a haste 2 beacon, which is something I dearly and definitely need here, because a haste 2 would make my cut my time of doing this probably in 3/4. I mean, if this is going to take me, say, 5 hours total, I imagine a haste 2 beacon would probably make it last like 2 hours. But, you know, it would be fun if I had that beat going doo-ch, 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 doo-ch. Just something I should probably do. We'll call it the collecting blocks song. Hey, you play Minecraft? Well, here's one for an efficiency 5 pickaxe. And if you have an efficiency 4, here's a song for you. And if you have a wooden pickaxe, here's a song for you. It's ambient. No beats at all, because you never break blocks that way. So, Black Sabbath's speed, you know. Dong, 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 boom, boom. Real slow. So, how's my pickaxe is still showing some red, so I can probably get some more without worrying about breaking it. Yeah, another thing that was highly annoying, when I died from the creeper blast in the middle of the cave where I had no idea where it was, a zombie had recovered my my mending gear, which is really awesome. But I had already made this second set of mending gear, which was too bad. But when I came across a zombie that had all my mending gear, and it was a farmer zombie too, one of those villager zombies, which is, I love the way they look in this 1.9 with the villager clothes all ratty-tatty on them. But anyways, I was so excited when I beat him, and I beat him in a water stream that was heading towards lava. So I'm like, oh, the guy died, and I saw all my armor like in the lava stream heading towards lava. And in my excitement, I grabbed all the stuff, and then I went to try and run away from the lava, and I hit, instead of hitting W, I hit Q, and threw my brand new pickaxe that I had just replaced into the lava. So I had to remake this pickaxe with Efficiency 5, Silk Touch, Unbreaking 3, Mending, which I had just remade and had yet to use. I was just so excited and panicked from trying to get my excellent diamond gear all with mending from going into the lava that I sacrificed my pickaxe. And you know what? I would sacrifice this pickaxe for saving a set of diamond armor any day. But I just thought it was like, oh man. All day yesterday, it felt like all I was doing, instead of getting better at the game, not better, but moving forward in my world, I was doing baby steps backwards and having to redo everything over and over again. It was kind of upsetting, but, you know, I haven't had a day like that on Minecraft in a long time, where everything just seemed to go wrong. It'll be like, if I just use this pickaxe that I'm using right now a little too long and it broke on me and I wasn't able to mend it, that would kind of suck too. But we'll see. I've got a little bit of red left. Let's see what the durability is left on this guy. We got 90. That's not bad. Yeah, I could finish this easily. Then we're going to go run over to my blaze spawner. Hey, you know, Pat, I know you love to be hit with my pickaxes and stuff, but please don't. So we're going to run over to my blaze spawner after I drop off all these blocks and replenish my pickaxe. Let's go. Ayama, yama, yama. Let's, do I have room? I do. Okay, let's throw all my blocks away because I don't like holding on to all my blocks. I do have some holes over here. Oops, I don't want to put you in there. So hello to you people who are maybe not in the stream right now. I'm not really looking at my comments right now. I do click over and look every once in a while, but I wasn't prepared for this particular stream. It's kind of a test stream right now, just to see how things go. And so far, I think everything's going pretty well. I guess I'm not too upset. Ooh, there's something green back here. What are you doing coming from my chest? You better not. Fucking asshole. I saw you sneaking. That would have been bad if you snuck and blew one of these up, motherfucker. I do have plenty of wood. I would have recovered, but it still would have sucked. So, let's go for a little run. I have yet to finish this part of the nether because it's like 7,000. Where's my... Oh. Wow. It's about 1,000 blocks away from my spawn. It's 7,000 blocks from my spawn in the overworld. Okay. No, that's not too bad. I'm not going back to my spawn, but I'm just saying that this is very far away from my main hub, and eventually I will be filling this up with water temple type blocks. You'll see my design eventually when I get to it, but seeing that this is going to the water temple area, that this particular pathway will be water temple blocks. This goes to a jungle, so I will widen that up. And I'll make a jungle-looking path that way. This path goes to a mesa, so I'll make a cavern, a pathway, a way to walk. Heading that way, that will remind you that it's a mesa area, so I'll use all the different mesa colors. But this main area will still stay Guardian Farm, because this is the Guardian Farm is going to be the main reason why I head out this way. Because basically, once I get the Mesa blocks, I'm not going to head out to the Mesa ever again. And all the colors that come in the Mesa naturally, I already have two double chestfuls of all the different clays, other than the light gray one. And I have a little bit more brown to find. Brown was hard to find in the Mesa, at least. So. And I still left all my quartz here. I'm not a big quartz fan because quartz is so expensive. I'll use it as an accent block, but not as a main thing. Here's another tunnel to the Mushroom Island, and of course that will be mushroomed up. Probably the main blocks being the polka dotted mushroom blocks with some not mycelium. Yeah, mycelium, that's the stuff that's in mushroom lands. And this would still be the guardian colored blocks, which will be green and of course orange, because when you do guardian based colors, you gotta get that orange in with the green so you look like a guardian itself. But as you can tell, this is a long effin' tunnel. I showed the tunnel and my last video, which was just basically a speed up of all the work I did one day after the day I felt good enough to play this game again. I just wanted to do menial tasks and basically just recover from surgery. I showed how I went through the pickaxe about 4 to 5 times, just breaking blocks. But this is like how my tunnels usually look. It has the bars on the side and different things for the needed areas. And the reason why I chose these blocks is that my blaze farm, these are the different blocks I use to accent the blaze farm. So I know if I'm on this path, I'm heading towards the blaze farm because I in my head know what the blaze farm looks like. Pretty smart there, eh? So, let's see if there's any wither skeletons waiting for me at this level. Nope. My little secret passageway over here. And here's my blaze farm. There's the blaze. And this is what I was talking about, the different blocks I used for the blaze farm. It's the same blocks that were in that tunnel. So basically, I take my clothes off because this pick is Silk Touch. And some reason when you have the diamond armor on, hold on. When you have the diamond armor on, the. There we go. The. XP from killing something goes to other places other than where you want it to go. So I'm holding my silk pick, so that's where I want the XP to go. But nobody wants to actually watch me AFK at a blaze farm, so I'm gonna call this test stream and end right now, and I am gonna end it. I do hope you like it if you actually saw it. It looks like I'm dropping a lot of frames, so it's a good thing that I did do this. But anyways, have a good day, guys, and maybe this will show up someplace. Goodbye.